Hey guys, welcome back to Husband and Wife Cooking Show. Today we're going to show you how to make green onion or spring onion lachcha paratha. This is also a Chinese recipe, so they call it spring onion pancake, but we're going to show you how to make in a manner like everybody's going to love it. So we're going to give it some Indian twist. You can see some spices here. So we have 3 cups of maida, all-purpose flour here, and we have 3 big spring onions. I mushed it a little bit, so you know all the onions, the rings can come out. And then I have some salt and some ajwain, to put it in the atta when we make a dough. And then we have some red chili powder, and we have cumin powder, we have salt to taste, and some black pepper and oil. This is 3 tablespoons of oil, which is going to go into the dough. So let's start making the dough. That's the main thing. So we'll start making how to make the dough of this paratha. So let's start making the atta. So I'm going to mix, this ajwain and the salt here, and we'll pour it in the, atta. So this is an Indian way. You can skip the ajwain if you don't have it. It's basically a Chinese recipe, but we're trying to make it in Indian style. So, a little spicy. Chinese also, they eat spicy, but this is with some Indian twist to it. So I added the 3 tablespoons of oil in it. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna start massaging it. We'll start massaging it like this. So with my both hands, and then I'm gonna, keep massaging it for a while. Finally, I'm gonna start adding the water and make a dough out of it. So this way, the salt and the oil and everything is gonna mix together pretty well. So keep doing it for at least like 10 minutes. And then we'll start, adding the water to it. Massage it like this. You can also do it in the, dough machine also. You can also, use your other hook, which is kind of blender hook, and you can mix all this together, and the oil is going to mix together. But this is an old style, traditionally, when people never had the dough hook and dough machine, so they used to do that. And so this is, I think it's pretty much done. When you stop feeling the lump, that means this is almost ready, and then we can add the water in it. This is a very important process, so don't skip it, because this will bring the crispiness to the paratha or the pancake, whatever you want to call it. So even in the original Chinese recipe, they massage it too. So we gotta give it a good massage here. As much as massage we can do, you will have a better taste, and you will have a crispiness in the, a crispiness. It's something like samosa or, kachori or something like that. So let's start making the dough, and we'll add the water slowly. Like you can see, a little bit of water and not too much water. And then we'll start making the dough here. Mix the, start mixing the, the flour to the water, and see. So we'll make a tight dough here, not too tight, but we'll try to make a tight dough here, and keep mixing it. So, we massaged the water and the flour for a couple of minutes. Now we're gonna start adding the water a little bit more. So this is 1 cup of water, and we can keep mixing it, and it's a regular process of making a dough. I hope you know how to make a dough. It's, anybody, just add the water, keep mixing it, and in few minutes the dough will be ready. So, and then we gotta create the gluten in it. I'll show you how to do that. So let's keep mixing it for now. So this is 1 cup water for 3 cups of flour. That's the measurement. We don't want too dry. We want a little bit, you know, soft. So done. So we'll start kneading it, and you'll see in few minutes this will be ready. So as you can see, the dough is ready. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna start creating the gluten. I have some oil here, so it doesn't get stick to the, you know, to the board. And then we start kneading it with both hands. Put some pressure on it, you know, create the gluten. You'll do this for like at least, you know, 5 minutes to 10 minutes. And then we'll let the dough rest for at least 20 minutes. So we'll do this. You know, keep doing it. What you have to do, you have to do this, like stretch it and then close it, stretch it and then close it. So this is definitely a Chinese, you know, way of creating the gluten. That's what they do when they make noodles too. So let's do this for a couple of more minutes and I'll show you. So when you see the dough has gluten, it won't have this friction. I can see this is, you know, kind of like not mixed together well. So I'll show you in 5 minutes how it looks like. As you can see, the dough is ready. So what I'm gonna do, I have applied some oil on top of that, and then I'm just gonna put it in a bowl and cover it for at least 15 minutes and let it rest. Let's do that. So jab tak wo, so meantime the dough is getting ready, we can mix spices into, you know, the green onions. So I have this red chili according to our taste. I mean, if you want, you can reduce it or increase it according to your taste. You can also use the chili flakes, but I'm using chili powder here. I mean, add the salt according to your taste, not too much, because you know the dough also has salt in it. And then we'll just mix it thoroughly and it's ready. So this mixture is ready to go into the paratha or the pancake. Meantime, our dough is getting ready and it's more than 15 minutes. So I'll show you how the dough is ready and we'll start making the paratha. It's a quick process and it's a very quick recipe. So you don't have to wait for a long time. If you want, you can skip the, you know, dough leavening process to 15, you can save 15 minutes. You can just straight away make the paratha. So this is ready. I'll show you, the dough is also ready. So you see the dough is also ready and we'll start making the paratha now. So you can see the dough is ready. So what I'm trying to do, I'm making 6 parathas out of this. And you have to make something like this, kind of like this ball size. I mean, you can tuck in all the extra here and 6 portions. And then we'll start making parathas. So we'll start rolling it up. I've taken one portion and roll it. So what you have to do, roll it as much as you can and try to make in the round shape. If you can't, that's okay, but roll it as much as you can. That will, you know, give us more crispiness and flakiness as much as we roll. So let's roll it as much as we can. So see, this is how much I've rolled. I've applied some oil on it and this is how much you could roll that small portion. I'm trying to even it out, give it a good shape, and then we start. What we do, we apply some oil here, like this. And then what do you do? So this has more crispiness. So I'm applying, you know, the filling here. You can see the filling is applied here. So dragging it on the top. So we start rolling it from there. So this is how you start rolling it. Slowly pick up one portion at one time, like one side, and start rolling it up. You can apply as much as all you want, but I like, you know, not too much oily. We try to make everything healthy. So you can see we are rolling it. I'm rolling it, rolling it. This is rolled, rock and roll. See, This is a long, kind of like a stick or a thing, like a long stick here. You can stretch it if you want. You don't have to, but you can stretch it so that we will have more rolls, more twist. So we can apply some oil here on this thing, like on the stick, and then you can start rolling it this way. So you can see what I'm doing here. And then you tuck this in like this. Tuck this in, and then we can start, you know, rolling it again, because now we gotta make the lachcha paratha or the pancake. So we roll it gently because it has filling in it, so we don't want to pressure too much, otherwise the filling will start coming out. And we just do it gently. So see, this is rolled out and now this looks like this. So this is something like 6 inches of diameter I could get. Some of the onion came out, but you know, that's okay, it will come out because I made like a such a thin layer of I rolled out so much, so this will give us the crispiness. That's okay. So now the oil is already ready on the pan. We'll start what we'll do is we'll just put this on the pan. So you can see I've lifted it up, and we'll just put this on the pan slowly. And what we have to do is we have to cook it on a slow heat, not on high heat, because this has to be cooked thoroughly. It's because it's pretty thick, so you have to cook it thoroughly. And you can take some extra oil, so this can cook it thoroughly, and all the oil can go in the layers we created. So we're supposed to cook it for at least 5 minutes on one side, and then we'll turn it on the other side. So what I've done is I've flipped it on one side after 5 minutes, and this is how it looks. Little bit of onion is out, but that's okay. It's even good because it's gonna give you some taste on your dough. So as you can see, this is like crispy brown color, and another side is getting ready. So within 5 minutes, this paratha will be ready. So guys, see this is completely ready, and it looks very crispy, just like samosa kind of crispness. And this is completely brown and looks so beautiful here. You can see all the corners and edges are beautiful. So this is ready. Now we'll serve it with some achar or pickle or ketchup. We can eat with that. Let's serve it. So guys, this has been served, and you can see we have decorated some onion around it, and this is the paratha. Looks so yummy, I just want to eat it. And this looks very crispy. You can eat this with pickle. So I'm basically going to eat it with pickle, but if you have ketchup or any kind of sauce, if you have hoisin sauce, Chinese sauce, you have soy sauce, hoisin sauce, this will taste good with hoisin sauce. Hoisin sauce is really amazing and it's really tasty. You can try with that and pickle, kimchi. It's going to taste good with kimchi also. So try this recipe. Let us know how did you like it, and give us comments and give us thumbs up and subscribe our channel. I'll see you next time, in a different with a new recipe. So see you next time. Bye guys, bye and take care.